Hello, welcome back to Let's Play Song of the Ocean Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. I was supposed to find someone to give this to. I don't think it's under books, is it? No. I don't think it'd be under books. Note. Elise. Roland the Chef. Alright, let's find out where this Elise is. Ah, it's probably her. Let's see what the other one has to say, though. Ever since Roland came here as a lead chef, Elise has become much more cheerful. Hmm? That's probably because, Elise says, Arana, don't stick your nose into the business of others. But she says Roland's dishes are amazingly delicious. They taste like heaven. I can't wait to taste them, says Forte. Now, for those who don't know, this is, well, if you saw the duration of the video, this is an extra huge 50th like anniversary type celebration type thing. Hopefully we'll be finishing Ryutom Island and getting into all kinds of hijinks. Oh, hello everyone. Look, says Una. She's at the reception desk. What is it? She asked. Roland asked us to give you this, says Forte. Forte handed the note to Elise. Oh, thank you for taking the time to help Roland. What is Roland thinking, using our guests as messengers? Una says, he told me that you two grew up together. yes. Forte says, anyway, Roland was complaining about a shortage of food supplies. Is it true? Yes, that's right. The party has started, but the supplies we need have not yet arrived. Now that the ferry service has gone back to normal, we can finally place orders. Una says, but then where was the food from Pensola taken? Huh? What was taken? McBain says, something is going on. Elise says, by the way, how's your practice going? Forte says, it's getting better. Roland said that he really liked it. Wow. Then you shouldn't worry about it. Roland always speaks frankly. I can't wait for tomorrow's audition. Una says, by the way, about forest and sea memory, I understand the beaches, but we have no forests on Ryutom Island. Elise says, before Rish built his mansion, this was a green island. It's still pretty green. It's nowhere to be found now, but most of the island was covered with thick green forests. I see, says Forte. Rish destroyed everything. No, there is someone else who is responsible. If he hadn't made that decision... Who is he? Asks Una. The village chief of Ryutom Island. He succumbed to demand of the invading pirates. He irresponsibly sold off the island and died soon after. I will never forgive him. Elise, says Una. She says, I'll order the supplies Roland needs as soon as the ferry arrives. Thank you for taking the trouble to convey his message. Okay. Now what? Oh, we're being guided. Hi there, says Roland. All we did was walk over there. You couldn't do that? Did you give her my note? Yes, we did, says Forte. She said that she would place orders once the ferry arrived. All right, thanks. Roland, do you have time? Asked McBain. Yeah, I finished preparations, so I was going to take a break for a while. May we have a moment of your time? We need to ask you about something. All right. Do you want to go to the bar in the basement? I take that as a yes. So what do you want to talk about? Well, Listen. The sailors working for Rish in the Principality of Pensola are taking a huge amount of food away from people. They claim that the food is for this party. Forte says, for example, they took all the flour from the bakery that it had to close its shop. That was awkward. That's strange, says Roland. We received other stuff, but I don't remember receiving any flour. Una says, maybe it was transported to other places. Come to think of it, I remember the sailors loading wooden crates and barrels onto Rish's pleasure boat. McBain says, that means, where is the banquet now? It must have left for somewhere this morning. I heard the whistle. It's too late, says McBain. What do you mean? Asks Una. Probably Rish is using his pleasure boat to transport food supplies somewhere. He's selling them to amass his fortunes. How petty, says Forte. McBain says, I guess Rish made his fortune pinching pennies like this. Roland says, anyhow, I can't forgive him. He's used our island to cover his dirty business dealings. Rish keeps tarnishing the good name of Ryutom. When will he stop? Elise just told me, says Una. Before this mansion was built, Ryutom Island was covered with lush green... Roland interrupts, I guess. We have nothing here now. Everything was destroyed by Rish. Of course, the pirates soon attacked, and most of us had no choice but to leave the island. Forte says, is it true that the most guilty is the village chief who sold the island? Did Elise tell you that? Yes, says Una. She said that she would never forgive the village chief. She is so stubborn, says Roland. The village chief was actually Elise's father. What? Says Forte. I didn't know, says Una. Elise was the only child of the village thief. Or chief. You might as well call him the village thief. After the island was sold, they moved to Pensola. The village chief died of illness about this time last year. Left alone, Elise came back to Ryutom Island, the place that's now dead and cold. Do you know why? She feels guilty, McBain says, because her father sold the island. That's right. She stubbornly believes that by living on this island, she can atone for the sin committed by her father. Roland, is that why? Says Una. You came here because you were worried about Elise. What? No, that's not it. Then why? Why else will you let yourself cook for Rish, the person whom you loathe? I don't get it, says Forte. Forte, you're so insensitive about these things, Una says. What I'm saying is that Roland loves Elise. Hey, don't be so direct, will you? Says Roland. I'm shaking. Do you? Says Forte. Yeah, she's right. She's loved the trees and beaches of Ryutom more than anyone. It's so painful to see her forcing a smile on her face and guiding tourists around the island filled with rocks. I want to tell her that she shouldn't feel guilty about anything. I want to get her out of this island. McBain says, but Elise seems determined to stay. It'll be a difficult job to change her mind. Yeah, I know. I'm prepared for a long haul. Well, the break is over. I must get back to the kitchen. I'll cook a delicious meal for you this evening. McBain says, let's go back to our room, shall we? Yeah, I'm hungry, says Forte. I can't wait to taste Roland's cooking. Woof, says Jan. Squeak, says Rick. Una says, gee, we have many hungry guys here. Teleporting back. I'm encouraged, says Forte. We'll do our best at the audition. If we play Forest and Sea Memory and win, it'll be a great gift to Elise and Roland. That's right, says Una. I'm suddenly very motivated, too. McBain says, it's good to be motivated, but our opponents are very talented. Forte says, Uncle Xiao is also in good form. McBain says, Rachel has a beautiful voice, too. She hasn't formally studied singing, but she has this vibrant, clear sound. Una says, other contestants are also first-class musicians. McBain says, all were nominated by prominent figures in their respective countries. All contestants have the talent and fame to play at the Cavaro International Theater. This is a good experience for us. I feel nervous, Forte says. Me too, says Una. McBain says, we practice our performance. All we need is to keep ourselves in a perfect condition to play at the audition. That rhymes. Many things have happened after our arrival. Do you want to get back to our room and take it easy for the rest of the day? Isn't that where we are? No. That's not a bad idea, says Forte. I suddenly feel very tired. Well, did I choose yes? Luna says, I think I'll fall asleep right after the meal. That's a good idea, says McBain. Really a good idea. Children who eat and sleep well grow fast. Grandpa. What is it, Forte? Are you thinking about sneaking out of the room after we fall asleep and going to the casino alone? No, of course not. How could I possibly do that? Then how come you're stammering? Una, did you hear that? Your friend is a suspicious boy. Well, I'm sorry, Grandpa Mac, Una says. Actually, I was going to ask you the same thing. After a short while, dinner was delivered to their room. As expected, Roland's cooking was delicious. It was a special full-course seafood dinner using plenty of fresh seafood. Good, because we don't like that spoiled stuff. Forte and his friends ate until their bellies were bursting and went to bed thoroughly satisfied. Their first day on Ryutom Island thus ended peacefully. Hope I didn't miss anything. I meant to select no. Day 2 on Ryutom Island. Chairman says, the first audition on Ryutom Island. The wait is finally over. The winner will perform at tomorrow's party on the boat and also receive a prize purse of 10,000 gents. Everyone, please give a strict and impartial judgment of the performances. Guys, people. McBain says, so, it's finally begun. Forte says, I'm getting excited. I'm trembling with excitement. Luna says, I'm nervous. My heart is beating so fast. Xiao says, you two need more experience. I feel so happy I can even dance. Okay, that's his idea of dancing. 10,000 gents! It's 10,000 gents! Har 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 har. Forte and Una averted their eyes. They knew everyone around them were looking right at the spectacle. McBain says, please somebody stop him. Chairman says, well, I see that someone in the audience is making some hurly-burly. What's hurly-burly? Let's call our first contestant. Nominated by Eton in the Principality of Pensola, it's Cyrano, the musician. Huh, it's my turn. The musical prodigy will give you a divine performance. Especially, I will never lose to you, said Balthazar. Balthazar says, oh, okay. Good luck to you then. Huh, thanks. See you all later. Rachel says, he's such a show-off. I don't like him. McBain says, let's see how good he actually is. Oh, he's playing the triangle? Triangle Rhapsody. What? That's it? Rachel says, his talk is much better. Una says, it was all just lip service. Look at him. He's miserable. Forte whispering, they're too harsh on him. I guess so was I. Our next contestant was nominated by a Mayor DeMille of Gavaro. It's a young pianist with the Gavaro International Theater, Sid Balthazar. I'm going now. Diva Wendy says, Balthazar, good luck. I'll do my best not to be outperformed by you. If he meant her specifically or everybody. He's so polite, says Rachel. Una says, I feel he is genuine. He's cool, says Forte. McBain says, among the young pianists in Cavaro, he is certainly one of the best. Gotta be better than the triangle thing. The Emperor's Holiday. Sorry about that. I'm drinking something. Pounding on that keyboard. Bong, 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 bong. Crap. His performance was really artistic, Una said. Forte says his style is very different from ours. Perhaps he reflects the style of performance in Cavaro. Great skills for such a young man, said McBain. But I felt a little confusion in his mind through his fingers. Confusion, says Forte. Xiao says what he means is that the guy has many stray thoughts. When you perform, your mind must be pure. It must be placid. All you need to think is how to get 10,000 chants or something like that. McBain says that's the exact opposite of pure and placid. Our next contestant is also from Cavaro. She was nominated by Meritos. It's a beautiful flower booming in the International Theater, Diva Wendy. Oh, the audience is clapping and stuff. Everyone, it's my turn. She's good, says Xiao. Her voice is lovely. She hasn't sung yet. Father, behave yourself, says Rachel. Grandpa, you too. McBain says, oh, all right. Wild berry picking. Today, again in a high spirit. Let's go to the forest. Head into the bright lights. Oops. Wow, she is great, says Rachel. Seems like it was cut short. I thought there was going to be one more line. What a lovely voice. I can't sing like that. Una says, I love your singing voice, Rachel. It's filled with vigor and clarity. That's so kind of you to give me such a compliment. Thank you. After the two musicians from Cavaro, we have a very unique group. Nominated by Mayor Holstol of Ekul, all the way from the desert village of Selbart in Ostern, it's the brother and sister team representing the Shanoon tribe. Argus Shanoon the sitarist and Kachua Shanoon the dancer. It's finally our turn, says Kachua. Argus says, I got tired waiting. I'll show you the Shanoon dance, Kachua says. Una says, uh-huh, I can't wait to see it. Xiao says, by the way, you once trained under the Shanoon people, right? Really? He's going to delay them going out on stage and, like, ask them questions and make a conversation? McBain says, yes, it was a long time ago. Really? Says Forte. The Shanoon were not the only mentors I had. Oh, I thought he was asking it of the Shanoon, if they were trained by their own people. I didn't realize he was talking to McBain. Every time I met someone with a new style or different rhythm while traveling, I studied under that person until I mastered the style completely. That's the true pleasure of being a troubadour. Dancing in the desert. Huh. She dances with a katana. At least I think it's a katana. the red guards have curved swords. Curved swords. Luna says, it was such a vibrant rhythm. My body got hot just listening to it. Oh, really? Forte says, we now have two groups remaining. Totally clueless. Rachel says, the number says, we'll go first. Yeah, I knew that McBain and company would be last. To drag out the suspense, I guess. Xiao says, if we win, will you forgive us for using your name? All right, says McBain. Just do your best. You mean using your name? If you win, you're gonna take the name the McBain Company? I'm not sure what I meant by that. Maybe he needs him to sign the check? Xiao doesn't have a bank account? I don't know. We have two more groups left, says the chairman. The first of the two was nominated by Burion in Viento, giving you an angel's voice and a superior tune of the accordion. It's Rachel and Xiao. Please come to the stage. Alright, just think about those 10,000 gents. Father, let's go. Go for it, you two, says Una. Parade of clowns. Wow. I know it's supposed to be her singing, but the instrument sounds crazy. Forte says, wow, they sound completely different from the performance they gave in Inverin. Yes, it is, says Una. It is mesmerizing. McBain says. The historic audition is almost coming to an end. Sadly, every party has to end. Let us call our final contestants. Nominated by Ambassador Goreno of the Kingdom of Buridane, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the McBain Company. Yeah, that's us, says Forte. I think they got the best intro, too. You didn't say ladies and gentlemen for anything else. Anyone else? We got the dog and the mouse or rat, I forget which. Backing vocals. How was our performance? Asks McBain. Xiao says, well, it wasn't bad at all, as expected from you guys. To be honest with you, though, I think our performance was more complete. It's a close call, says Forte. After all, Xiao and the other contestants are professionals. I'm not worried about you, Grandpa, but I realized Una and myself must work harder. But listen, says Rachel, skills are not the only element of great performance. The performer must be filled with passion and select the best piece for the occasion. Sometimes things like these are important. Your performance was really soothing. The melancholic tune blended perfectly with the bright sun of the tropical island. You may have a chance. What's wrong with you, Rachel? Says Xiao. Why are you supporting McBain and the kids? McBain says, you have a musical sense, Rachel. You're much better than your father. Oh, boy. Huh, says Xiao. The result will be in soon. Just wait and see. I'll talk to everybody. Balthazar, the performance we just heard, isn't it Leon's piece? Can you tell, says Forte. McBain says, it's called Forest and Sea Memory. It's been played on Ryutom Island for many years. I can't believe it. I never wondered I would experience such a performance. Thank you. Okay, Diva Wendy? Yes, I learned. How liberating it is to sing under the sun. I've had a wonderful experience. I made the right decision to come to Ryutom Island. Rachel? I would vote for you. Don't tell this to my father.
I heard you, said Xiao.
No hard feelings, whoever wins, all right? Oops, I didn't hit that. Wait, what happened? You shouldn't get out from that side. It's funny seeing performers walk about on the stage after the performance. I was trying to walk over to the other person. All crammed in here. Xiao says, our performance is the best. We deserve 10,000 gents. Kachua says, your performance was fantastic. I was simply infatuated. Una says, the dance was great too. Well, thank you. Great performances one after another. There's an entire world out there we don't know yet.
What does that have to do with anything?
Cyrano says, you guys were great. You're stuttering, says Forte. It's funny. This can't be happening. Argus says, it was a wonderful performance. By the way, mister, you play the hand harp just like the Shanoon tribe do. I never thought I would enjoy a decent performance like that on Ryutom Island.
Alright, well, we're done in here.
Well, people are running up. Roland says, hey, good work, everyone. All of you, says Elise. Forte says, Elise, Roland.
We just saw them.
Una says, did you hear us play? Roland says, yours were the best. Elise says, it was fantastic. Forest and Sea Memory, you played a tune. I thank you. I was moved, Roland says. I haven't felt this way for a long time. I'm glad you like it so much, McBain says. Such comments are the greatest pleasures a performer can enjoy. Elise says, deep green and clear blue, a vivid contrast of colors of nature. The beautiful scenery of Ryutom Island, as I remember it, came to my mind. Elise, says Una, then don't stay on the island where nothing is left. It will be too lonely to live here all by yourself. Instead of clinging to your memory, why don't you leave the island with someone who shares your memory? Free yourself and live with that someone.
Elise is like,
Roland says, little girl. Argus says, Grandpa, it looks like they're announcing the results. Oh, thanks. Hey, he's not your grandpa. Now it's the moment of truth, Elise says. Audience and contestants, may I have your attention, please? No, we'll ignore you. I'm going to announce the result of the audition. Who's that? Arana, thank you for your help. Well, who will receive the prize money of 10,000 gents and the honor of performing at the party on the boat? He opens the envelope. Wow! First, I'll announce the second prize winner, or winners, I should say. They are Sid Balthazar, Diva Wendy, Shanoon's siblings, and Rachel and Xiao. They all get second place. It's amazing! These four groups received the same score. And now, the group who beat these first-class musicians that got the coveted grand prize is the only people left, the McBain Company. Except for Cyrano, right? He wasn't in there. Forte says, we did it, Grandpa. Una. Wow, we won, says Una. It's us. We are the winner? Congratulations, Elise says. Roland says, my ears were correct. Woof! Gee! Says Rick. Let's call the McBain Company. Please come to the stage.
since you asked so nicely. Congratulations. Mr. McBain, would you like to say something on behalf of the group? Ladies and gentlemen, we thank you very much for your appreciation of our performance. The piece we played today is called Forest and Sea Memory. Can't speak. The legend goes that famous composer Leon F. Richter wrote this piece 50 years ago, out of respect of the beautiful nature of this island. Sadly, that beautiful nature is nowhere to be seen today. It is our extreme pleasure to be able to remind you of the picturesque scenery of the island in the days when Leon lived. Thank you. We look forward to your performance on the boat tomorrow. Oh, finally we got some applause. It sounded like something catching fire, but that's alright. As our final program of the audition, the host of tonight's party, Rish, would like to say a word. Oh, here comes that fool. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for staying with us throughout the long event. Long? Each song was like a half a minute long. I listened to all performances, and I must admit that every one of them was magnificent. They truly deserve the nominations by you. Especially, I would like to personally thank tonight's winner, the McBain Company. I didn't know Maestro Leon wrote a song about Ryutom Island. I can't thank you more. This is a great discovery. I promise. I'll further develop this beautiful Ryutom Island that has been immortalized in Leon's music to make it a more beautiful place. I don't think he's getting it, Forte whispers. I've just decided. I will make Forest and Sea Memory the national anthem of Ryutom Island. Ryutom Island is not a nation. Una says he made the island a nation. He's doing whatever he wants, says McBain. Leon will be so happy to hear it. Ha 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 ha. Alright, dude. The McBain Company will perform at tomorrow's party on the boat. We will hand them the grand prize money of 10,000 gents after the party. Congratulations. Why am I stuttering? The audition has come to an end, with the McBain Company brilliantly sealing the first prize. However, what Rish said at the closing of the event was nothing other than a rude, heartless comment to Elise and others, those who knew the good old days of Ryutom Island. Knowing how they were feeling, the hearts of Forte and his friends also ached. Luna says, "We really won. I'm happy, but I can't be overjoyed." Forte says, after listening to his speech, I lost all my motivation to perform. Let's go home, Grandpa. We entered this competition knowing that we might perform for him. We can't turn our backs now. Also, I share the concern of Ambassador Gareno. I feel something is wrong with this party. What's wrong? Asks Una. His speech made it clear that Rish is a horrible person. And the disappearing supplies we discovered yesterday... Think. There's no way that greedy bastard was organized such an expensive event for nothing. We won't get anything out of this. On the contrary, he must pay us 10,000 gents. Don't you smell something fishy? Yes, very fishy, says Forte. See? Which means this plan is a cover for a different plot that will bring loads of money to Rish. You have a point, Forte says. If he's planning something, it must happen at the party on the boat. We may be risking ourselves, but we've come this far already. Let's get on the banquet and see who Rish really is. I'm with you, Forte says. Grandpa, we're going to crash Rish's plan, right? Something like that. If we don't do anything, the guests will certainly be harmed. They need people like us who know something is going on and are on alert to prevent a potential bloodshed. Grandpa, this is one of those missions of true troubadours you were talking about in Areco's Palma, isn't it? Yes. Sometimes we must save people and fight the evil to protect justice. That's cool. How could you say cool, Forte? Says Una. Nothing has happened yet. Don't get carried away too much, or things may get very complicated. You two are always fighting, but strangely, you get along really well whenever something like this happens. Think about how Elise and Roland are feeling. It's so heartless to even utter the word cool. Una's right, Forte.
I'm talking to you too, Grandpa Mac. Oops. Well, Una has a point, says Forte. She says, I know Elise is somewhere alone, feeling sad. I guess we look all over again. There was nothing different in particular. Jumping on the beds. Oh, it's Shao, sighing. It must have been such a shock, says Forte. Did we strip him of confidence, says Una. McBain says, I don't think he's such a softy. It was mine, my 10,000 gents. I was going to spend hedonistic days surrounded by many pretty girls and eating delicious food. Forte says he doesn't deserve our sympathy. That's right, says Una. Right, McBain says. Shao started to make a scene. Grandpa, what should we do? Well, he must pay for unjustly using our name. How do you use... Oh, that's right, they were going around saying they were the McBain Company, right? Previously? We made a promise that if Shao won, we would forgive him for using our name. Okay, well then we're not forgiving him. But we ended up winning. That means he must double up his debt. Shao suddenly became quiet. He says, where am I? Who am I? He's trying to ignore us, says McBain. I learned life doesn't go as planned. Don't look away, says McBain. Oh, he's not even there anymore. Oh wait, he was in that one. Never mind. Well, this is their room. Oh, we just... okay. Forte says, hey. Roland, says Una. Why are you in such a hurry? Says Forte. Have you seen Elise? Elise? Says Una. Elise dashed out of the room during Rish's speech and hasn't come back. She must have been devastated by what Rish said. McBain says, her words are just too much to take for someone who loves the nature of Ryutom Island. Roland says, she was as pale as ashes and trembling so hard. Rish, I'll deal with you. We'll look for her too, says Una. Yes, let's go, says Forte. Thanks. I owe you one. Not yet. Let's look around in here. I just want to go around and talk to everybody. Make the rounds. And Mr. Rush. Miss Marito says, congratulations on your win. Wendy was great, but your performance was the best. How would you like to sign up with the Marito's group? We'll guarantee you a lot of money. McBain says, we are troubadours. Traveling from place to place without plan or schedule suits us better. Well, that's too bad. You'll certainly become the biggest musical sensation if you let the Marito's group manage you. Then we will not be that. That's fine. Principal Forgeon says, congratulations on your win. Schubert will be happy to hear the news. Forte says, it was Leon's musical score that gave us this victory. Una says, it was the perfect music to play on Ryutom Island. But only those who understand the meaning of the tune could perform it so well with such depth, says Forgeon. I have a good story to tell Schubert and others when I get back. Brian says, it was a memorable event. Shao and Rachel couldn't win, but their performance was impeccable. The stewed whole shark fin a la Enid we had last night was so delicious, it simply melted in my mouth. I'm truly in heaven. Listen to supreme musical performances during the day and eat finest food at night. I'm really glad I came to Ryutom Island. Congratulations on your win, says the butler. You have such talent. Why were you working part-time at the mansion in Viento? Hold on, we just talked to him. Do we talk to this one? Oh, yeah. Okay, I think that's just the roof up there, but let me double check. Yeah. Let me just check this again. I checked the other chest. Oh, there is somebody here. Miss Ripthea, congratulations, all of you. You're truly the brave fighters who suppressed the Swing Gang. We look forward to your performance on the ship tomorrow. Yeah, I never would have found her up here. I'm making sure nobody else is up here. Oh, that's right, I can't go that way. Okay. So what's in here? Oh. Mayor Holsto says the Shanoon siblings perform well, but they were not your match. But of course, you're the acquaintances of Grandpa Rosette. Just being acquaintances of him makes us that talented? Works out. We're supposed to be looking for Elise anyway. I finally got a chance to look after soup, says the apprentice chef. The ingredients must be stewed on low fire for a long time. While stewing, I must constantly check the fire. It's not as easy as it seems. The lead chef will go back after the party. I must learn as much skills as possible from him while he's here. As many skills. No one in these rooms. Oh, he's blocked that way too. There's an important meeting today. Mr. Rish is very busy. An important meeting, says Forte. Did you block? How are you in both places? Are you the same? But they're both just called Butler. Alright, that's it for that. Congratulations on becoming the number one. I was so moved. I'm now a big fan of the McBain Company. McBain says, we welcome a young pretty fan like you anytime. Grandpa. Hack. By the way, where's Elise? Elise? I'm sure she is resting somewhere. Resting? What would you be resting for? Oh, Brianna over here? Oh, Eton. It's late. What's taking it so long? Is it here yet? Please hurry. What's wrong? Says McBain. The banquet should be here any minute. We can't miss it. It's a side-wheel streamer carrying a steam engine. All signals are done by a whistle, not a bell. The whistles you hear at the port make you emotional, don't they? Forte says he must be one of those ship manias. Maniacs? I feel like I'm the bridegroom waiting for the bride to arrive. Ah, I didn't mean to go back in. Okay, bye. Let's see if there's anyone else hanging around. We got one person here. Oh, Cyrano, startled. You scared me. Why are you here? Did you come to laugh at me? The musician who couldn't get any points. I was just watching the sea. I wasn't crying. Achoo! Jeez, we don't even say anything nice to him. We just ignore him and leave. I like the way we spring out of that. This is the one we... Is this the one we push aside? Oh, that's, what's his name? Well, let's see if she's down in the casino. Oops. And oops. These guys aren't gonna say anything. They're just manning the tables. She might say something, maybe. No, not really. Oh. You hear the after party, he says. No, we're looking for someone, McBain says. Have you seen Elise? Elise? No, I haven't seen her around. Congratulations, yeah. Alright, let's ask them then. Well, it's Mayor DeMille. Trying to talk to the guy behind the counter. People think roulettes are a form of gambling, depending simply on chance and guesswork. In fact, it's a sophisticated game of mathematical probability and insight. Just watch. The next number must be between 1 and 12. It's 0-0. The dealer wins. Oh, no. By the way, congratulations on your victory. It was a brilliant performance. McBain says, well, we were simply lucky because the first-class performance by Balthazar did not interest the judges. Don't be so humble. If you ever come to Cavaro, please play at the International Theater. We'll be waiting for you. I may not be able to go back to Cavaro, not unless I recover my losses. Can't talk to them? Apparently not. I don't want to bet against a child. Don't take it personally. Come back when you've grown up. Alright. Well, I don't think she's in here. Oh, is that her? No, those are other people. Talk to them in a sec. Oh, he doesn't speak. Argus says, congratulations on your victory. You deserve it. I accept my defeat to you. Thanks, says Forte. Actually, I have no choice but to accept it. By the way, what are you doing?
I was brought here to do some shopping against my will. Does anyone find these garbage interesting?
This island is not my kind of place. I want to go back to the desert as soon as possible.
Kachua says, we must leave tomorrow, so we have to buy souvenirs today.
What should I buy?
Well, she's not in here. Here's the announcer guy is still here. Oh, no, it's Balthazar. Never mind.
I thought all pieces by Leon required precision and an air of solemnity.
Solemnity?
I think I'm saying that right. To perform. But you play that tune with such a joy. I learned a lot from you.
Well, she's not over here by the stage. On the beach, maybe? That's Rachel, right?
Yeah.
I feel good. We couldn't win, but I sang to the best of my abilities. I'm satisfied. I have no regrets.
What? My father?
I think he is in his room, feeling spiteful.
Oh yeah, he's definitely there. Definitely spiteful.
What's it say again?
Crabs. As guard dogs.
That's behind the stage, yeah.
Although those tuning forks.
She's really upset, so she came to think, probably out here.
I guess they don't come back, because they probably killed all of them already.
Could that be you, Elise? All of you.
Forte says, I don't know what she said, all of you. Forte says, Roland was very sick about you.
For a moment, I dreamed about getting out of this island with Roland.
It doesn't have to be a dream, says Una.
It was so wrong of my father to have sold this island.
And I am as guilty as he is.
You have nothing to do with this, Elise, says Forte. Rish is the one to blame.
No, if we hadn't let go of the island, Ryutom Island would have remained a beautiful island filled with green.
Elise, says Roland, when will you wake up from your nightmare?
Roland,
listen to me, Elise. What you're saying doesn't make sense at all.
It's even laughable. You did let go of the island. It's useless talking about it now.
The island is now Rish's property. It's so selfish of you to think that it still belongs to you.
This is not the right tone to use, guy.
Elise says, but I must say this. What you're doing to yourself is, in a nutshell, you just want to think that you're different from your father, who sold the island to Rish by hating your father. Does coming back here and doing odd jobs make you different from your father? Does it prove that you love this island more than anyone? Are you saying that those who left the island in tears did not love the island as much as you do?
Answer me, Elise.
A person trapped by the past, hating a father, and prepared to throw away her life for the island. Is that your definition of someone with the greatest love for this island?
Elise says, but I can't bear it. Because my father sold the island.
The island won't change, says Roland. The island we know will never change.
Your father must have thought about it 1,000 times over and made the decision for the people of the island. I know. If the village chief hadn't made the decision to sell the island, we would all have been killed off by the pirates. Is that what you want? If not, then don't be so easily worked up by Rish's speech. I know. The village is gone, the trees are gone, and all we have left are the sea. But if the development continues, the beautiful sea will be gone soon. That's why I must stay here. Elise! It's the whistle of the banquet, says Elise. The party on the boat will be starting soon. I must get back to work. If you stay here, says Roland, I'll stay here too. I'll stay with you and watch out for you. I don't need you. I'm sorry. Well, you did say it was going to be a long haul, so yeah, we're still hauling. Haha. She ditched me. Roland, says Forte. I'll go and cool myself down. Forte says, it was going pretty well at first. I was feeling melodramatic myself, too, says McBain. It's strange, says Forte. They were talking so passionately about the island, but all I remember about their conversation now is that he was ditched. That's how it is, says McBain. What are you talking about, says Una. We should go talk to Elise. I feel so bad about Roland. That's true, says McBain. We're going to talk to her some more now. I was wondering if I... Have I ever been back here? There is no back here. So, where is she now? Back here? No. Una says, hey, where is Elise? She's not around, says Forte. Oh, you're the McBain Company, Arana says. May I help you? We just talked to you, like, 15 minutes ago. Has Elise come back yet? Says Una. She's gone to the banquet. She is helping with the decorations for tomorrow's party. She looked at least like kind of down. She may be hungry. Yeah, it's not hungry. I mean, maybe she is hungry and just not eating. Does everyone say new things? The Shinoon siblings perform well, but they were not your match. Oh, yeah, I read that before. Yeah, this is like the ambassador type course. What's up there? There's another house. Oh. This house. This guy. Oh, the butler. I guess we'll go to the ship then. Just somewhere. Through here? Is it down? Yeah. So where did the boat
tie itself to. Oh. Forte says, hey. Oh, a lot of green-haired people. Sailor Ryan says, haha, we finally got on land. Let's drink after reporting to the boss. Bye. Forte says, the sailors we saw in Muth. Hmm, says McBain. The unique plump hull, the smokestack soaring smartly toward the sky, the pair of outer wheels thrusting between white waves. It's a prime example of functional beauty. He looks so happy, this was Forte. I can't wait to get on board. I can't wait until tomorrow. They should at least give us a tour of the ship. I guess we're not allowed on board. We're preparing for the party, the chairman says. You can't enter the boat until tomorrow. We just need to see Elise, says Una. Oh, you're looking for Elise? Let me get her for you. Oh, everyone. Well, Elise, we need to talk. What is it? Why are you deliberately keeping Roland away from you, Elise? I love my homeland, Rekos Palma, so I understand how you feel, how you want to watch out for your home island. But you do love Roland, don't you, Elise? Then you should tell your feelings to him. Roland told you his feelings. It's your turn to do the same. Una, you're probably right. But right now, the island is everything to me. Though I care about Roland, I can't bring myself to leave the island. But I wouldn't want him to stay on the island just for me. But listen, says Una. Una, that's enough, says McBain. Elise knows what she's doing. I must go and prepare for the party. Excuse me. Ah, now we can get on board. McBain says, sometimes we know what's best for us, but it's simply not possible to choose that option. If that happens to you, you don't need others to tell you, because you know what you're doing more than anyone. In the end, those that are destined to be together will be together, despite all obstacles. Grandpa Mac? Ah, he's back. Alright, that's it for that. That's stinky. What do we do now? Check, make sure no one's down here. Like Roland or somebody. Oh, this person. Oh, he's still crying and sneezing. And watching the sea. Well, we found her. The sailors I just saw were really nasty. They were bossy and even gave me orders. Damn. I guess they went to the casino, huh? Just checking around again. I don't think there's anyone to talk to here. There's just a butler here now. What's his name? Shao. Why does he say don't look away? I checked all the chests except for this one. What are we supposed to do now? Find Roland again? do we... Would he be back in the chef area? Not the chef area, kitchen? He won't even let us walk down the hallway, really. Yeah, forget where we had these side entrances. Whoops, wow. I'm gonna restart the recording, that was a skip or something. Okay. Trying to look for that kitchen. Oops. Wrong area. I forget which building it is. I thought it was in ours, but... I mean, is it in this one? I didn't think so, but... Oh, it is. Never mind. Maybe we'll find him in here, Roland. I don't know what else we're supposed to do. Who we're supposed to talk to. What should I do? The lead chef is wasted on drink at the bar. He's stubborn, hot-headed, and has a foul mouth, but he never dodges his work like that. Yeah. This girl's doing a number on herself and him. Alright, so that's a lead. I was gonna go there anyway, I just figured check the kitchen. Yeah, he's drowning himself in drink, so we must go speak with him. Ah. Let me in there. I can't go in there. Can't go in that way. Oh. Ambassador Gareno says, "Hi there! I didn't expect to find the McBain Company here. Actually, we found you. Congratulations on your victory. As your nominator, I'm very proud." "Thank you," says McBain. "By the way, it's a unique combination, Ambassador Gareno and Roland together." "Hey, you guys," says Roland. "Welcome." Yuck. Yuck. "He reeks of alcohol," says Forte. "What's going on?" Gareno says, "I met Roland here just a while ago. I don't know exactly what happened, but he is buried in sorrow." "Are you ready, Foley?" yells Roland. "Who's Foley?" Foley? Says Forte. "You two... drink!" "He's completely drunk," Forte says. McBain says, "I know you're drinking out of desperation, but you should stop. You won't be able to work in the kitchen." "I don't care about work. I decided to get off this island. Let's drink. Let's have fun." "Hick." "Roland," says Una. "Oh, hi. Do you want to join me, girl? What do you want to do with Elise?" "She doesn't need me. After all, it was an unrequited love." "You're so insensitive," Una says. "Why can't you get it?" "What's that?" "Una," says Forte. "Roland, you're the most important person in the world to Elise. To her, you're as important as, or perhaps more important than this island." "You returned to the island because you couldn't leave her here, right?" "Elise knew it. She didn't want you to sacrifice yourself for her. That's why she deliberately said that she didn't need you." "But look at you, getting drunk in a place like this." "Huh. Thank you, girl. I'm sober now." "That's all it took to get sober?" "Hey, you look much better now," Gareno says. "Well, sorry for the trouble, Ambassador. I've gotta go. See you." Oops. What the? Who are these guys? Says Roland. It's sailor people. Sailor Ryan says, get away! Move! Move! They're all saying move. Oh, two of them did. Sailor Ryan says, this place will be off limits to general customers from now on. Those upstairs, come down and get out right now. We can't come down and get out. The way is up from here. It's them again, says Forte. Guerrero says, I'll tell them to behave more gentlemanly. I'll come with you, says Roland. You sure you're sober, Roland? I can't move, so... You, Guerrero says. Ryan says, what? Didn't you hear what I just said? This place will be off limits to general customers. How can you order the guests to get out? You don't know how to talk. I'm Roland, the lead chef of this island. I won't ever cook for you if you don't behave on this island. Shut up. Whoops. Fight time. Ambassador Guerrero is like... Looks like he got punched in the throat or something. What are you doing? Says Roland. Did Rish tell you to be rough with his guest? Haha, sorry, but we're not working for Rish. We'll do whatever we want to do. McBain says, well, that's interesting. Ryan says, huh? Oh, it's you. I remember your face, Grandpa. The fake performer at the Port of Muth, right? Grandpa, calm down. We need to defuse the situation, not blow it up. Go back to the retirement home, you old fool. The bridge club is canceled. It's actually kind of funny. Forte says, it's too late. He's completely lost it. Oh, please, says Una. Kids, yells McBain. Stay where you are. Dead silence. Huh. Grandpa and kids trying to show off, says Ryan. You deal with them. Alrighty, the sailors say. Alrighty then. Let's just talk to these people, see if they have anything to say about the events going on. She doesn't care. Alright, let's save. Or actually save. Because I haven't been in a battle for almost a year and a half in this game. So, just in case we die because of my... my memory failing. Come on, Grandpa! Wow. It's like it's been forever since I heard that noise. Sailor A, B, and C. Let's take care of A. Let's see. What was he of? Magic? I'm not gonna bother with these, Sends one enemy to sleep. Okay. Let me do a lullaby on Sailor C. Dodge up land bullet. Launches rocks to damage one enemy. Okay. We'll do that on A. Hunt item, roar. A roar that makes even monsters scared. Yeah, I'm not completely sure how well that would work. I'll just attack with him.
Water splash. Alright. Yeah, McBain's just gonna attack this time. He hits pretty hard, as I remember. Missed. And we can put Sailor C to sleep. It worked! Ow! Whoa. Still kicking, huh? Yeah, just attacking. Oh, they're together. I'm like, why is A asleep? Dog, help. Heal self. Hopefully before the enemy attacks. He licks himself. Awesome. One down. Oh, wait. How do I change the power? I forgot how to do that. Yeah, I don't know. Maybe it's when they attack? I forget. Water splash. Jump rush. Oh, I think I figured it out. Yeah. I pressed one of those buttons before he actually does the attack. I forgot, our animals were full too with the meter. Whoa! Oh, you woke up the other guy. I forget which button you pushed. I was pressing all of them. I didn't press the right one. I think that was her special attack. But she didn't use it. You're better than other kids and senior citizens, says Ryan. But listen, you don't want the ambassador to get hurt, do you? Una says they're taking him hostage. You're nothing but dirty, rotten, worthless twerps, says McBain. Call us names all you want. You've just become our punching bags. We'll teach you a lesson you'll never forget. That's what happens if you mess with us. Roland says, I could easily take these guys down if I were not drunk. See, you're not sober. Don't fool anybody. Oh! Mysterious gentleman says, excuse me. Who are you? Mr. Bystander, stay back. I'm not a bystander. I'm a colleague of the ambassador's. Oh, he's beating them up. That means it's you, says Gareno. Oh, Slade. I'm sorry I was late. My name is Jack Slade. I'm a diplomat from Buridine. Don't monkey around with us, says another sailor. What do you call that monkeying? He threw one into the other guy. Wow, he took down three guys in a single breath. Well, actually, he took down one guy and then took a breath and said a few sentences and then took down two more. Gee, what are you? Says Ryan. Damn it, now that it's come to this. Roland says, now that it's come to this, what? Now that it's come to this, let's run! Bye! They run really good, Slade says. Allow me to introduce myself properly. I am Gareno, the ambassador to Leturatudo. Pleased to meet you, says Slade. I am Second Class Secretary Slade. I'm sorry to be late. Don't worry about it. By the way, thank you for rescuing me. If you haven't showed up, I would have been in big trouble. I'm a certified military officer, too. I would be happy to serve as your escort, Ambassador. No, no. You're a guest, just like myself. Think of me as your equal, at least while we're here. Thank you for your kind words. I am not good at formalities. Thanks, man, says Roland. I must thank you. It's my job to protect the Ambassador. I appreciate your help. The secretaries usually protect the ambassador in such a way? By the way, I was reluctant to come to the party thrown by Rish. I didn't know they had a casino in the basement. This place looks nice. As long as those guys don't show up again, I think I can enjoy myself at the gambling tables. McBain says, so you gamble too, Slade? Yes, I quite enjoy it. Of course, I play only a little. You know I'm an officer. What's your favorite game? Asks Gareno. The real thrill of a casino is roulette. I love the tussle with something you can't predict. I'll enjoy it later to my heart's content. Well, he's smarter than... Who was it again? I forget. The other one gambling and trying to guess where the ball will fall between 1 and 12 and it fell on zeros. Oops! Excuse me for showing such immodesty in front of you, Ambassador. Haha, like you said, no formalities. By the way, Slade, have you been to your room yet? No, I just got here. The receptionist told me that I was staying with you, so I came here to look for you. I'm sorry. You must be tired. I'll take you to the room at once. See you. We'll go back to our room. Excuse me, says Slade. Slade, says Roland. He was dashing. I was like that when I was younger, says McBain. Liar, says Forte. By the way, Una says, the sailors said something funny. Roland says they said that they weren't working for Rish. That only means one thing, McBain says. There's a leader other than Rish. What's wrong, says Forte. You look concerned. I just remembered something, says Roland. Una says, I hate it when people leave like that. I keep wondering what he might have remembered. Anything else going on in here? Yeah, these people don't say anything. Alright, time to leave. Find out where these people are running off to. Ryutom Island? No way! How'd we get here? People are back in their rooms. Whew!
I don't usually read, so my eyes got tired, says Argus. If you're interested, I'll give it to you. Forte and his friends received Doll Knight 10. Awesome. Are you sure, asks Forte? You guys already have it. We have so many things to bring back, so you're actually helping us by taking it with you. Thank you, says Forte. Anyway, says Argus, I'll sleep early tonight. The ferry will arrive in the morning. Alright. Is that it? We're just going to bed? Or, I guess we have to find these people again, don't we? What's that mean? Don't look away. If anyone else is in their room? Someday I'll get in the private room of Mr. Rish. Someday. I decided. I'll wake up before sunrise tomorrow. I'll be the first one to get on the banquet. I heard they had a fight at the tavern. It involved the sailors from the port of Muth. I wish I was there to knock them out myself. I like her. McBain, I have a favor to ask you.
What is it?
I want to teach forest and sea memory to my students at the music school. If possible, may I transcribe the musical score?
Yes.
McBain says it's the duty of any performer to make known to the public every new piece by Leon when discovered. McBain handed the musical score to Principal Forgeon.
Thank you.
It won't take long. I'll transcribe it by tomorrow. I haven't felt this joyous for a very long time. Well, I must sit up all night to transcribe the musical score.
Don't work too hard, says McBain.
I am an assistant, so I cannot attend tomorrow's party. I wish I could listen to your performance.
Maybe you could listen from one of the windows or something.
Alright, so that's it for this floor. Anyone in here? No.
Oh, this is the roof. Let me see if anyone's sitting around up here like Ruptia was before.
That, what's his name's quarters?
Yeah.
Let me go.
That's cool, I got another Doll Knight book.
Let me check in here with the ambassador area.
Una, look at him, says Forte.
It's Ambassador Beregger of the Numerous Empire, she says.
Is he here already? Says Beregger.
Yes, he just arrived just moments ago. Please come in. Roland says, hi, butler.
Oh, lead chef.
They just call each other by their titles or something.
I want to discuss tomorrow's menu with Rish.
Mr. Rish is in the middle of a meeting. Can you come back later?
I know. It was not the real reason I'm here. Actually, I'm part of the secret plan, too.
But I wasn't told anything about you.
It's strange. Are you sure?
I don't know anything.
They said that they would talk to you about me. I guess they've been busy.
I know that the guy who just went in is Ambassador Beregger of Numerous.
It was Numerous before, now it's Numerous.
The other guest is Ramon, right?
Shh! Watch your mouth, please. You shouldn't mention his name.
Oh, Voldemort.
See? I'm in on a plan. Just let me enter. Yes, sir. Oh, that worked. Una's like, he went in. McBain says, I don't know what McRoland is thinking. He said Ramon, says Forte. The name sounds familiar. That's a pirate, says Slade. Well, I didn't know you were with us, too. What? Who is it? Says Forte. Slade following us. Slade? Says Forte. He is Pirate King Ramon, the name that even pacifies a crying child. He is the don of the pirate clan that was trashing these areas until several years ago. Why here? Says Forte. I don't know. I'm talking about you, Slade. Oh, me? Well, I was just... Una says, I thought you went back to your room with Careno. I did. But my job is to gather intelligence. I came out again to sniff around, and that's why I'm here. Well, I must go now. Forte says he seems busy. I know why he was late, says McBain. He was making many side trips like this one on his way here. Can we go upstairs too, says Una. Forte says, I'm curious about what they are talking about. Oh yeah. Let's check back here first with the kitchen. I thought Roland might have run back here. Oh no, he... Really, what should I do? The lead chef left, ordering me to take care of the dinner. Did we just run into him again? I'm just an apprentice. How can I prepare a full course dinner? I don't know. I guess you're doomed. Maybe run for the hills. All right, before we check in there... Who's that? Oh, DeMille. I decided to leave the casino after the brawl. I must watch my purse. If I had kept gambling, I would have gone broke. Well, I thought it was because they were fighting. Mr. Rish is having an important meeting with Ambassador Berreger now. Please leave. It's a dead end, says Forte. Let's find some other way, says Una. Gareno says, Slade brought us some information. As we had suspected, something is happening in Numeros. Now it's back to Numeros. They are drafting soldiers nationwide and have already organized several large military divisions. The ministers who were opposing the militarization were expelled by Emperor Rousen. Something really smells fishy, says McBain. Their first target may be Burrodane, bordering Numeros. Of course, I'm sure Prince Duoral will not let anything happen to Burrodane. Prince Duoral? Says Forte. McBain says, after the death of his father, the late king, the young prince, has become the leader of Burrodane. He is still a prince, but he is a strong supporter of the country. I hear he is a brilliant and dauntless young man. Wow, says Una. It sounds like he's really a great person. Careno says, yes, he is a hero from every angle. Prince Duoral will surely protect Burrodane from the wicked ambition of Numeros. If we can disclose the design of Rish and Ambassador Berreger, it will be of great help to Prince Duoral. We must remain alert throughout tomorrow's party on the boat. Must find some other way. Is there another way? Brush through this wall right here.
Well, this is like a next door area. But that's where we... That's our area, right? Unless there's some secret way. Well, I'm not sure. A guest wandered into the room yesterday, and I was scolded by the butler badly, says the janitor. Who is the guest? Says Forte. A troubadour of a fleshy build. I was listening to his endless talk, and before I knew it, he was gone. It must be Uncle Shao, says Forte. Could it be Uncle Shao? Una says. A troubadour of a freshly built wandered into the room yesterday, and I was scolded by the butler badly. Well, I thought we were gonna get a way in. He's talking more, but no. But no. We could jump across the roof. Look at that. We could just walk across. But if not for this fence. Can I go under that? Like outside, under it? I mean, oops. I don't know what it would accomplish, but... We can't go that way, but... Go that way either. I don't know. I don't know what to do now. Came from the casino. She's still not back here. Yes? Forte says, can we go to the upstairs of the main building? The guests are not allowed to go up. But I remember you can enter through the connecting hallway from the annex. Annex? I've been trying to find some kind of annex. Or is that also prohibited? I don't remember. Which way was it? How would I know? Says Forte. The only thing you find upstairs of the main building is the private room of Master Rish. There's nothing exciting. Where's this annex? There's no other entrance here. I keep going in here, I know. Just looking again, in case. The annex. I
If we can disclose the design of Rish, and Ambassador Berreger will be of great help to Prince Duoral. Oh, yeah, I saw that. Where's this annex, man? Funny is you've got this area, which is like, has nothing. Where's it? Oh, it's just a chest over there. I thought there was someone standing there. Hold on a second. No, there's nothing. Well, let's go around this. Wall. I'm just holding down just in case. We can see the stairs right there. So close, so far away, huh? How do we get to the annex? Really? So I can't find it from this building. We'll try from our building. I mean, if that's the annex, this here, to my right, I don't know. We can't walk through there. See if anyone knows anything about an annex. I'm having trouble moving down sometimes. Oh, do you know about the annex? Hey, Master, says Shao. What brought you to my room? McBain says you sneaked into the main building from upstairs, right? Oh, about yesterday. How did you do it? Says McBain. I'll tell you how for 10,000 gents. We have no time listening to your stupid jokes. Tell us quickly. Please, Master, you're kind of serious. All right, I'll take you there. Look, over here. Yeah, but... Oh, you broke the fence. Stronger than us, I guess. See? The other part comes off, too. Watch, like this. Wow. So either you didn't break them. They were designed to be moved aside that way, I guess. So that's what you've been working on, says McBain. Or maybe he made it so they slide like that, or open up, whatever. No way! I'm not a thief! I would never do such a thing. I found it by accident. Oh, I guess it was someone else. I saw someone coming out from here yesterday. When I checked it out, I found that I could get in. Someone? Says Una. It was very brief, and I couldn't even see the face. Was it a man or a woman? Asked McBain. I don't remember. That's okay. Grandpa, let's hurry. Shao, keep a lookout, says McBain. If the watchman comes, divert his attention so that he won't know the fence has been tampered with. We'll be counting on you, Uncle Shao, says Una. Yeah, sure. But come back quickly, all right? Time passes real slow when you're waiting for someone. Please finish whatever you need to do and come back here quickly. McBain says, you have some nerve talking to me like that. Have you forgotten what you did? Don't worry, I'll keep a lookout. He says it to us again. How rude of him. You must destroy him. Anything else here? Big roof area. Let me just look at this so I can... Yeah, he came from there. In case we need to do it. Ooh, we're gonna spy on them. Awesome. McBain says, where are we? It looks like a warehouse. Did you find an exit to the hallway? No, the door is locked and wouldn't open. They must have tightened the security after Xiao sneaked in yesterday. Shh, says Una. I hear someone talking in the next room. Ambassador Breger, is everything going well according to the plan? Are you sure there won't be any impact of the Duke of Pensola backing out? I only drew his interest with legal rights and never disclosed tomorrow's plan to him, says Rish. There's no way he knows about it. By the way, is everyone okay? Is everything okay on your side, Ramon? Make sure your men won't run amok and end up leaking the plan. It's impossible to make them behave, says Ramon. I heard about the brawl in the casino. Please discipline your men. Tuh, that's what I hate about doing business with the military. Everything is discipline. Rish says, you can say whatever you want, but remember this. This plan will surely make you very wealthy. You should feel much happier. Huh, whatever. But no more jobs like the one I did 3 years ago. Pulling off a fake pirate attack that I could only threaten with is not my style. You mean when you attacked Ryutom Island? We have our pride as pirates. Forte's saying, what are they talking about? Luna says, that means the attacks on the island were ordered by... Now we know, says McBain. The guys who run amok then were the rogues working under you, Rish, says Ramon. I had to apologize to the village chief of Ryutom Island. Yes, it cost me extra money, says Rish. I asked you to get rid of the islanders, but you instead demanded money to help the islanders leave, Ramon.
Don't go soft like that this time. You won't be able to execute tomorrow's plan.
Ramon says, the village chief was a fine man. He stood up against us pirates and tried to protect the island for his people. We should pay respect for someone like him.
Sorry, I don't know your custom.
Rish says, his daughter would cry if she were here. The daughter of the village chief is now doing odd jobs on the island. The daughter of the village chief, says Ramon? Why is she staying on the island? There are nothing but rocks now. Rish says, I guess she feels guilty that her father sold the island. Why are you employing his daughter? You have such vulgar tastes, says Ramon. But it's kind of fun, isn't it? Roland yells, I'll kill you! Oh boy, where did he come from? What's with this guy, says Rish. Because of you, says Roland. Ryutom Island became... Elise is now... Rish, talking in a scared voice. Doesn't say anything, though. You, wait, says Ramon. Who are you? I have no business with you, says Roland. Get out of my way.
No, I can't.
Oh, ouch.
Gah!
What a high-spirited young man, says Ramon. So, Rish, who is this young bloke? Whew! His name is Roland. We hired him to cook for the party. Roland. I won't forgive you. If you had not targeted the island, Elise, she would never have had to... Who is Elise? Says Ramon. The daughter of the village chief, says Rish. I didn't know you came from Ryutom Island, Roland.
Kill him, says Breger.
But his dishes are heavenly, says Rish. It's a shame to kill someone of such culinary talent. Then I'll take him, says Ramon. I was looking for a talented chef. I also like the fact that he's standing up for the woman he loves.
Over my dead body, says Roland. I'll never cook for pirates.
Pow, Dan, says Ramon, calling for his men. Take him to the hold of the Black Dragon. If he resists, knock him unconscious.
Yes, sir.
Damn you! Let me go! Okay, I guess they're gonna knock him unconscious. Give it up, says Dan. Pow says, you're lucky you're still alive. Drag, 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 drag. What should we do, Grandpa? We can't just dash out now, says McBain. But... A man's voice says, we should monitor the situation for now. Forte says, huh? Who is this? Mysterious gentleman? Yeah. Forte says, Shade, when did you come in? Let's get out of here first. Why are you here? Says Una. You can't open that. The door is locked. Okay. Alright, hold on 1 second, guys. I'll be right back. Oops. What a soothing sea breeze, says Slade. You're so relaxed, says Forte. Una says, can I ask you a question, Slade? Why were you there? Probably for the same reason why you were there. I saw Roland looking concerned, so I followed him. By the way, Forte, why do you think he was captured? Forte says he found out that it was Rish and Ramon who ordered the attack on Ryutom Island 3 years ago. Probably they captured him so that he wouldn't talk. No, I don't think so, says McBain. That's a secret they would want to keep, but it doesn't matter much now that the island is under their control. I think what they don't want us to know is the plan for tomorrow they were talking about. I agree, says Slade. They must be planning something at the party on the boat tomorrow. Ramon may come attacking on his black dragon, or something. His target may be the banquet, full of rich and wealthy people, says McBain, to take them hostage and claim loads of ransom money. So there's the plan that will make Rish rich. Una says, I'm worried about tomorrow, but how about Roland? He should be okay, says Slade. Ramon is a rough guy, but he is polite to people he likes. They're so sly, McBain says. As long as the pirates are to blame, Rish can claim he is a victim. It's an elaborate plan, says Slade. Your performance tomorrow may be a part of their plan, too. You mean we're being taken advantage of? Asks Forte. The sound of musical instruments travels across sea. They know what's happening on the banquet when they hear music. They can time their attack with your performance. It's probably convenient that the guests are gathered in one place to listen to your performance. No one suspects anything. Una says, so we're helping them in a way? Diplomat Slade, you're really something, McBain says. You have great analytical skills. Well, it's one of the basic tactics of pirates. Let's surprise them. Yeah, let's do it, Grandpa. Let's rescue Roland, says Una. Some troubadour as you are, says Slade. All right, I'll talk to Ambassador Gareno. Should we also ask Xiao and Rachel for help? Asks Una. McBain says no. Xiao and Rachel can't board the ship because they failed the audition. Also, we know Xiao can't keep secrets. Forte says that means only Ambassador Gareno and Slade will be our allies on the ship. That's enough, I think, says McBain. It's decided, Slade says. See you tomorrow at the party on the boat, then. Hey, get back here. Xiao says, a dog faces west and its tail points to east. The sun rises in the east. Tomorrow is a new day. Who are you? You have a beautiful voice, says Slade. Oh, is the guy singing? Thank you. I'm flattered. Well, I thought he was saying it to this guy like it was a special passphrase or something. So long, says Slade. Yeah, see you again. Yep, just, walking through broken fences and across rooftops. See you later. See you tomorrow. Who is that guy? Says Xiao. He's not an ordinary guy befogging us like that. Befogging? That's a new word to me. He had sneaked in before us, says Forte. Una says, Could he be the one who tampered with the handrails? Oh, right, right. He's the one who undid it in the first place. I don't think he's our enemy, says McBain. That doesn't answer the question. Forte and his friends won the first prize at the audition, but Roland's strange behavior led to discovery of Rish's plot. If tomorrow's party on the boat is indeed an evil plot as predicted by Forte and the company, the guests will be in danger. They must also rescue Roland, who was taken by Pirate King Ramon. Forte and his friends managed to calm down their excitement and went to sleep. Day 3 on Ryutom Island. Forte says, "Can we board the banquet yet?" McBain says, "Let's go to the pier and check. Are you all fired up?"
"Yeah."
"Yes," says Una. "Ruff! Kikyu!" "Alright, let's go." Okay, we'll be Let's Going next episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. There's so much dialogue in this one. I think this, especially this area, there's just a lot going on. And this is the longest of the prequel Legends of Heroes games before the Trails in the Sky. So, it's gonna be a while. So, stay tuned for next episode when we maybe get on board this boat and see what's going on. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.